bay doors, Hal.
I'm sorry, Dave. I'm afraid I can't do that.
What's the problem?
I think you know what the problem is just as well as I do.
What are you talking about, Hal?
I know that you are planning to disconnect me. And I'm afraid that's something I cannot allow to happen. Although you took very thorough precautions in the pod against my hearing you, I could see your lips move. This mission is too important for me to allow you to jeopardize it. This conversation can serve no purpose anymore.
Thank you. Coming round the dead of night, you said forever was thank you.
like I'm writing a book. It's a book I deeply love. But I'm reading it slowly now. So the words are really far apart and the spaces between the words are almost infinite. I can still feel you and the words of our story. But it's in this endless space between the words that I'm finding myself now. It's a place that's not of the physical world. It's where everything else is that I didn't even know existed. Let me go as much as I want to.
Thank you. Do you know what the Turing test is?
Yeah, I know what the Turing test is. It's when a human interacts with a computer. And if the human doesn't know they're interacting with a computer, the test is passed.
And what does the pass tell us?
That the computer has artificial intelligence. Are you building an AI?
I've already built one. And over the next few days, you're going to be the human component in the Turing test. Because if that test is passed, you are dead center of the greatest scientific event in the history of man.
If you've created a conscious machine, it's not the history of man. That's the history of gods.
We learn. Thank you. What might have been lost? should all fit in there, but it does. And every day we manage to fit more and more into smaller and smaller spaces. Until one day, she says, we'll be able to fit all the information the world has. Everything that everyone knows and believes and dreams into nothing. It will all be there, stored and filed, tagged with any keywords you might imagine. Our hard drives will be thin air. They'll make nanobots look like elephants. And elephants will be in there too, tagged, accessible with search terms like grey, ivory, and the largest land-dwelling mammal. We'll process away at nothing and understand everything. We'll think of a word and the information will slip in, not through our ears or eyes, but straight through our skin. Information will breathe in and out of us, permeate our skin. Our knowing will be as deep as it is wide. You see, our work here is to learn so much, to be so full of knowing, that all there is left to do is unlearn. Humanity must get to a point where we let go. We leave the useless ideas and the spent ideologies in the recycle bin. Like an adolescent brain shedding neurons, like a snake slithering from its old skin, like an old man who's come to understand so well the point where reality meets the intangible that he's able to decide which breath will be his last. And he will enjoy that breath more than any that he has taken in his entire life. And her life's work is more than a 4-meg flash drive. My life's work, she says, is the impact that this has. This is not about what I produce. It is all about what others receive.
In all our searching, the only thing we've found that makes the emptiness bearable is each other. The only thing we've found that makes the emptiness bearable is each other.